Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at R. Smith of Spalding High School at the Cavaliers football team. I don't know how they did it. Kyle Schmitt, how did they do it?
Oh, man. A lot of heart. Yeah, the kids, I think we kept our composure really good.
Mm-hmm.
Came in at halftime and just kind of got some things situated. Mm-hmm. I think the biggest, probably, I know it, the turning point, obviously, we got it going real quick in the second, third quarter, but the defense holding them in the first half, mm-hmm. I mean, we gave them the ball in some really challenging spots, and we held them at the three field goals, I believe.
Yeah, three field goals.
Three field goals in the first half that could have been touchdown situations. Mm-hmm. So, our defense coordinator, Tyron, before we, I knew they'd get it right. They always do. They'd get it right, and, you know, on offense, we just had to finish it, and we got an incredible effort by Jay Numbarger, Chris Clark, our O-line, Jayon Venerable for a little while, Quentin Young right after him. I mean, Brevin Easton, Zaki Wheatley made an incredible play on fourth down there. It was really special. So
yeah, I mean,
just we can name them all, frankly. You know?
Right. Yeah, 28-25 win over Mount St. Joseph. I'm Derek Tony. That's Kyle Schmitt, coach of the Archbishop Spalding Cavaliers, as they win senior. It's a senior night, right, coach?
Was
it senior night?
It was senior night.
Senior night. We had rain. We had Poe or whatever Raven mascot. We had rain. We had dry, and then we had a thunderstorm and come through at the. Well, not thunderstorm, rain.
No thunderstorm.
I mean, everything just wildness. But again, just talk about the fortitude of this team, coach. Because I mean, down 23-0 against a very good Mount St. Joseph team. Mm-hmm. It was looking kind of not dire, but it wasn't looking good, fair to say.
we got a, you know, against St. Anthony's, we were down 21 in the fourth quarter and mm-hmm. came back. Mm-hmm. You know, this game, it was down 23 mm-hmm. at halftime. So we've been there before.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the thing you do, and Troy Gibson, my assistant's up in the game booth with Andrew Tense, our two mm-hmm. coaches, they handle a lot of the situational stuff. So that's why we went for two a couple times. And we knew, I kind of told the kids at half, we got to get it to two possessions by the fourth quarter. And then we got to get it to one possession, you know, at the 8-minute mark. And actually, we kind of got that. We got to do a possession, mm-hmm. right? The two possessions right at the end of the third quarter. We're down 9. So you kind of got to think of the game. You break it down at that point. You got no other way to do it. You can't just sit and think, oh my God, can't get it all back in one play. So
right.
You got to kind of chip away. And then obviously, you need the defense to step up, which they were awesome in the second half. But credit to Derek, to Rich and his, you know, group. I mean, Billy Atkins just playing his heart out. The poor kid misses the field goal to
right.
tie it. But the kid did everything he could to get him to win. 11 Thornton's incredible player. Marlo Wax, incredible player. So this one's going to be a fun rivalry for a long time. There's a lot of young guys on both sides of the field.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just glad we don't have to see him again this year.
Yeah. I mean, just talk about the season, coach. It's been a kind of a crazy season. You started with the game with good counsel, had, of course, some weather delays, crazy comebacks. I mean, it's been a hodgepodge of stuff. There's always something every week, it seemed like.
It's been something every week. I'm just so proud of the kids. It's just a special, special effort. We have incredible support. Started good counsel with that. Mm-hmm. We had a Friday night here where we didn't play against Benedictine. And then from there, it was just game after game. We had one running clock this year, last week. But everything else has been fourth quarter games. It's really challenged us situationally and made us play four quarters. I think that's probably part of the difference tonight.
Mm-hmm.
You know, St. Joe has had a bunch of running clocks. You know, I've been there before. It's a nice problem to have, but they haven't played a lot of fourth quarters. I mean, McDonough almost did this something very similar to them a couple weeks ago. And
mm-hmm.
you know, our kids are used to those situations. You know, we've played at the end of the game like that, and I'm a little overwhelmed, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I think everyone here who saw this game is overwhelmed.
It's a little overwhelming. I'm just thrilled. You know, I'm really happy to be a part of this program and have so many great kids. They're phenomenal. I mean, Jay Numbarger was incredible tonight. I mean, he was incredible. That kid is. We've had some ups and downs. He didn't start early in the year, and you know, he just kept. It was all about Spalding football for him.
Mm-hmm.
He's incredibly selfless. So I'm just lucky to coach him.
Yeah, and just talk about some other seniors who've been, I mean.
Yeah.
You have so many of them, still young.
Yeah, Logic Hudgens, huge pick down here, and then we kind of had him track number 11 a little bit. Zaire Allen on the other side had a pick the end of the half, first half to keep it. Those two were just special tonight. Sean Spencer, our safety. Adam Barkley is kind of the heart of the defense, number 8, gets us right. So proud of him. Stephen Cobbs, our DN, just played his heart out. Ethan Page got hurt late, number nine, our small and outside backer who just plays really, really, really hard. Wow. Justin Lopes got a start, number 30, was just walking out here.
Right.
Guy had played a ton of snaps for us and just balled tonight. Our center, Kate Gregg, was really, really good too. So he was really good. And, hey, 56, a great player. He's a great player. Yep. Kate Gray, our center, and just really proud of them. We got 4 out of 5 up front, our juniors, and we're young up there. Well, one sophomore, but they were all great. They were great. They're great kids. They want to celebrate. They deserve it. They got the weekend off, and you know, we're gonna play a little more. Donald Davis has put together some, you know, and some of us, since we're gonna get 2 more games here.
Okay.
To end the season, and hopefully, I think we'll play Riverdale next week.
Okay.
And then if we can win that, we'll get another shot at Calvert Hall.
Okay. So, well, I know you guys got a little unfinished business with the Cardinals. Yeah. Well, Kyle Schmitt of the victorious Archbishop Spalding Cavaliers, down 23-0 to Mount St. Joseph. They grind it back. And they win it 28-25 on senior night here at Whittles Field. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tony.